Welcome friends to OneStop Java Solutions. I am Sneasis and today I am going to solve TCS Proctored assessment of 28 December 2019. Okay. First question I have already solved in previous video. You can see link in the description. You can subscribe my channel to get notification on upcoming videos. And today in first part I already implement the movie object, movie class. Okay, and in the second part and in the also I create the solution class, and inside the solution class I have written the main method. So in the rest of the part you can see what you have to do. You have to create another class solution with a main method and scan attribute as above sequence. Okay, so there is four attribute. Okay, so you have to scan all these attribute. So to scan you have to write a scanner. You have to create a scanner reference to hold the scanner object. Okay, so scanner sc. okay, so scanner class is java.util.package, java.util package. So you have to import that. Okay, so if you right click here you can see import scanner java.util. so if you import the java.util, inside the java.util class scanner class is there. Okay, util package basically, the scanner class is there. Okay, so I am creating the scanner reference. Okay, and you have to store the you have to create the four movie object and you have to store in a movie array. So I am creating a movie class already I have created. So I am creating an array of movie. Okay, movie error. I am giving the name error equal to new movie, and size you can take any size. Here if you see in this question there is a four set of object. Okay, four set of movie object. This is the first set. Okay, next is the second set, third set and fourth set. So fourth, you have to create an array of four movie. Create the four movie object. Okay, so that thing is that. Then you have to take the input. Okay, so for that write a for loop for int I equal to 0, I less than 4, I plus plus. Okay, and inside the for loop you have to take the movie name, company name, genre and budget. Okay, these are the four attribute of the movie class. Okay, so you have to take the input for all these attribute and in four set. So you have to create the four movie object. Okay, so taking the input, just print a message that system.out.println, inside there write that enter movie name. Okay, enter movie name, then sc. sc is the scanner class reference. So in the reference I am referring one scanner object. Okay, so new scanner, and it will take the input from the console. So for that you have to use system.in. So pass system.in, system.in. So it will take the, so it will take input from console. Okay, and create one string variable and store the object, scanner class object to string variable. So sc dot next line. Okay, so whatever you have provided in the console it will take as an input and store it in a string variable. Okay, so you have to repeat the same thing for other string. Okay, so first one for the movie name, second one for the company. So enter here, just write company name. Enter company name. Okay, system loading and change this one as a s2. Okay, and third, enter genre. Enter genre, okay, and this is also a string, so store it in string genre. Okay, so you can store it in genre, and third one, or you can store in any of the other variable name, you can give anything. Okay, and start one is the budget, and it should be in integer. Okay, so system.out. The same thing you have to do, but here instead of string it should be int. Okay, and here the value you can write is, it is the budget. Okay, so int b, take as b, and enter write budget, budget, and system, and instead of next line it should be next int. For integer to write a take input from console, you have to use next int. Okay, so it's done. So whatever I have given, s1 s2, here you can write s3 instead of generally s3 use, and for budget use the b. Okay, now you have to create a movie object. Okay, so you got the four field values. Okay, now you have to create the movie object. So to create a movie object, movie class is already there, we have already implemented. So call the new movie, it will call the parameterized constructor that you have already implemented. So new movie, and pass the value s1 s2, then s3, then b. Okay, so movie object will be created, and this object reference you have to store in the movie array that you have already created, movie arr. Okay, so movie movie, give the name as movie equal to new movie. So this reference you have stored in a movie object, and then arr i, so first index is will store the first movie object, and subsequently in the second, third, and 0th index, then first index, second and third. So in the fourth index it will store the four movie reference. Okay, movie object. Okay, so this part is done. Then you have to, if you go to the question, then you can see create a static method getMovieByGenre, which will take the object array search string parameter that we'll create in the next video, and returns a movie which have matching get budget. Not this one. Website. Create another class solution with the main method and scan the attributes as ABAP sequence. Okay, then movie, this class will take another parameter, okay, array, and search string as a parameter, and returns a movie which is matching with the genre search. So you have to take another input outside the for loop, okay, genre, that you have to pass to that method. Okay, so here just write system.out.println, enter genre. Okay, that parameter you have to pass to the method, to that method. What is the method name? getMovieByGenre. Okay, so you have to send this movie array which contains the four movie object and the one genre value. Okay, so sc equal to new scanner system.out system.int and then the genre value. Okay, so here take string genre equal to sc.next line. So it will take one genre value from the console and store it in the genre. Okay, now you have to call the getMovieByGenre method. Okay, so you have to call, means you have to write that method and you have to call for main method. Okay, so that part I will describe in the next video. Okay, hope you can understand this part. Okay, thanks for watching this video.